So here now, Geraldo Rivera, Fox News correspondent at large and author of his memoir, The Geraldo Show. Geraldo, you listened to the discussion with the attorney. Your thoughts first on that?
Well, I think that he's in a tough spot, having been a defense attorney representing unpopular clients. I know that sometimes the world looks like a very cruel place to you. This crime, though, is sickening. He has a daunting prospect of representing someone who committed, in all likelihood, a savage offense. You know, it's a tough road to hoe. I don't hold it personally against the attorney. I'm far more annoyed, Martha, by the lieutenant governor, Dan Patrick of Texas, who defamed me by suggesting that I don't sincerely feel the pain of Mollie Tibbetts' family over the tragic loss of their daughter. It is absolutely outrageous.
Let's play it for folks at home, and then I want you to continue. Okay. Let's watch.
American citizens and people who legitimately want to come here aren't criminals. They're playing with their lives for politics. Again, the CNNs, the MSNBCs, most of the print media in this country and the Democrats, they are all accomplices in the death of this young girl and the death of everyone else. And even Geraldo Rivera, and I've never met the guy. I seem to like him. Seems like he's got a good heart. You know, I saw him here on Fox saying, well, I feel badly about this, but there is no but. And I'll be happy to debate Geraldo Rivera anytime, anyplace, anywhere on this issue.
We invited him to come talk to you tonight, Geraldo, but your response to what he said about you and about people he says feel like you do.
To be called essentially, Martha, you've known me and my wife Erica for more than 18 years.
I sure have.
To be called by that bottom-feeding politician an accomplice to this young lady's murder is something that I cannot abide. He is stereotyping 11 million people in our country here without documentation. They care for our babies. They mow our lawns. They wash our dishes. They pick our fruit. They pack our meat. They process our poultry. And to characterize that entire group of people as all of them murderers. In Colorado, you had this millennial guy with the beard, a white guy. He kills his pregnant wife, the unborn child, two of his babies. Do we then say millennials with the beards are a threat to society because of this case? This case in Iowa is an awful case. This person should be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. But what I was doing and what I am doing right now is begging people. I know that most of the Fox audience disagrees with me. But I'm begging you to have compassion and not brand this entire population by the deeds of this one person.
And that's what I was getting at with the attorney. The fact of the matter is that this person came here illegally. No one is saying that all 11 million people are capable of what this person's capable of, but put yourself in Mollie Tibbetts' family's shoes right now. It's bad enough to learn that someone who was living and working in your neighborhood murdered your beautiful daughter. It's worse when you find out that they crossed the border illegally, that they're not even supposed to be in the country. There's a process for coming into the country. There's people waiting online from many countries who are going through the proper process. So the fact of the matter is that he shouldn't have been here. And that adds to their pain and it adds to how awful the situation is.
The family of Mollie Tibbetts, I'm so glad that you brought it up, Martha. They have gone out of their way. The cousin now is on social media. The friends of the family are all saying Mollie Tibbetts would be horrified by the fact that this case is being used as an argument against unlawful immigration. They would be horrified. She wasn't that person. Anyone could have done this. Everyone, they do it on a daily basis. White people, black people, red people, yellow people, everybody, they do these crimes.
But everyone
it is horrible that,
Geraldo,
they do these crimes.
And I respect the family, obviously, and whatever they want to say on this matter, they are free to say and to speak out, obviously, in any way they want. But the fact of the matter is that he was here illegally. And for some people, that they look at that and they say, look, this is just another indicator. We have a terrible, lax process at our border. It doesn't work. And this person shouldn't have been here. He's not here legally.
We at this network are putting that spin on this story.
It's not spin, it's a fact.
This is a murder story.
Fact.
This is not an immigration story. It is a fact.
If
we're talking facts from the Pew Research Center and it's a fact that from the Pew Research Center and every other objective story, and in today's New York Times, for example, that is proven that the undocumented immigrants commit fewer crimes per capita than citizen Americans.
That's absolutely right. I looked at those numbers this morning. It doesn't change the bottom line, which is that this person who killed this woman was here illegally. So then what is the relevance? It adds to the pain and to the misery of the situation to know that not only did this happen, but it didn't have to happen. If we had a system that allowed people to come and go, and he didn't have to work under a name that wasn't his name.
This has nothing to do. This is feeding the false impression that this population increases violent crime. It is a falsehood,
and
to use this case to make that point is wrong.
And I'm glad you're here to make the point, and I would like to hear you debate Dan Patrick on this, and I hope that we do hear that, and I respect your opinion on it, and I'm glad you're here, and I thank you for speaking with us. And I love you, too. Have a great night, Geraldo. Bye-bye.